Hello everyone, my name is Nightmare and welcome back to the channel. So recently I've been looking around on YouTube at GT7 videos and I realized something. I realized that nobody really gives any love to the VGT cars. I know there's a whole bunch of people that really don't like them because they're not quote real cars, and that's fine, I get it. But I kind of like some of them. I use the Lambo a lot. That car's a blast to drive. So I thought that since nobody else really has, I'm going to show the VGT cars some love. And so I went and I sold a whole bunch of cars on this account, and I decided to go buy all of the VGT cars. Well, I didn't buy all of them because, like the Tomahawk, there's like four different versions of that car. We only really need to know about one, you know. Unless somebody specifically asks for a particular version, I really don't want to do four versions of that car. So, what I bought one, and I'm trying to avoid repetitiveness as far as the cars go. So, yeah, that's why I did that. So, what I'm going to do is I have bought all of the cars, and so I'm going to put them on racing soft tires. I am going to run a lobby that I have set up at Sardinia Road Track A simply because it's a good combination of high-speed areas and corners and handling areas. It's just a good all-around track for me. I know the track well. I'm pretty good at it. So, yeah, I figured I'd run those cars there and, you know, give them a good shot, good rundown. Shakedown, that's what I meant, shakedown. But yeah, so I'm going to do a little bit of a review. I'm a mid-B to mid-A driver. It depends on the week and what the dailies have been. So I'm not an alien. So chances are somebody who struggles like I do will have the same issues that I do with the cars. And so I figure I might be a good source to say, hey, look, this car will work really well for you if you're rated like I am, or if you're brand new to the game, it'll give you a good idea of what cars are easy to handle, what cars are rougher to handle, what cars are just undrivable, basically. So yeah, I figured I'd give that a shot, and if at any point y'all like what you see, like what you hear, please hit that like button. And if you would consider subscribing, I would definitely appreciate that. I don't have a huge community. If you have any suggestions for what I should do, put them down in the comments. If you think I should run on a different track, put it in the comments. The first one I'm going to do is the Daihatsu Copen. I'm going to go with that one because that one's a really simple one, easy to drive. But I will eventually get to all of them. They're going to be part of a massive playlist on the channel. So yeah, I hope you all stick around. I hope you all enjoy the videos. And here we go. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to run a time trial at Sardinia Road Track A. And so if that way all the cars will come up in their respective PP areas, PP ranges. So yeah, that's basically it, guys. I'm going to do that, and we're going to see which ones handle good, which ones handle bad, which ones are really super fast, and which ones are drivable, which ones aren't. So yeah, let's all have fun. As I said, for this time trial, we're going to be using the Daihatsu Copen, so we're going to go over here, and we're going to take a look at what the stacks are for it, and let's see here, Asia Pacific, Daihatsu. Okay, so we're going to take a look at the stats, just so you get a good idea of what you got going on. It's a small car, very small car, weighs in at 1,300 pounds, roughly 146 horsepower, so decent ratio. 660cc turbocharged engine, 149 pounds of foot-pounds of torque. So yeah, it's not a bad little car. It's not going to be super fast, but I think it will get the job done. We will see what she does. Alright, so I'm going to do a total of 5 laps in each car. This one's starting off. I've done this car a few times around this track, so I know how it handles pretty well. So we're just gonna go with the best lap, And the thing about this car, it's not exceptionally fast by any stretch of the imagination. It does handle pretty good, but you might notice here, coming up on this first turn, there's a little bit of understeer when you really hammer the gas. So, you know, it kind of is what it is. It's easy to control simply because it's not a fast car at all. Yeah, see, that through there, that was alright that first time. That wasn't too bad at all. The good thing about this car is, for a beginner, it's a good VGT car to get into, simply because it's not, you know, a million horsepower. It doesn't do 500 miles an hour. You know, some of the VGT cars are honestly just absolutely ridiculous as far as their power and the way they handle and the way they steer. So yeah, this is a really good get your feet wet kind of car. As you can see, it really struggles to get up this hill with any pace. It kind of stands to reason it's only 140 some horsepower, 149 or something like that. So it's not overly powerful. You get something like a Tomahawk on this track and it's going to go screaming up that hill regardless. But yeah, this car is actually just, it's a lot of fun to drive, honestly. And as I have, pointed out, I'm a pleb, guys. I am not an alien. I don't have the perfect lines, the perfect braking markers, the perfect anything. I do what I can do. There's some things I struggle with. You'll see this, you'll see some of my struggles coming up in some of the other cars. So, yeah, it is what it is. I'm out here to have a little bit of fun. I'm here to show the VGT cars a little bit of love, because despite the fact that a lot of people don't care for them simply because they're not, you know, they're not production cars, some people like them. Some people like to drive some of them. Some people have, I brought it up on Facebook. I asked people if they thought, in some of the Facebook groups I'm a part of, I asked them if they thought it would be, you know, kind of cool to have somebody do videos on all the VGT cars. And a lot of people told me that they've driven a few of them, but they haven't driven, they haven't driven all of them. So I think being able to provide them with some information, some input, a little bit of feedback on the cars themselves is not a bad idea. And I figure if nobody else has done it yet, well, I might as well try and entertain you guys a little bit, maybe give you some information you didn't have before. Why not? It's worth a shot. I've been wanting to do something like this for quite a while anyway, just something different. I ran the team channel for the team I used to be part of for years, 4 years, and I was always trying to think of a way to keep people engaged. And I never really came up with anything. I did our team videos, but I did 99.9% of the videos that were up there on that channel. And that being the case, I burned myself out really, really bad. So I stopped putting videos up for a while. Well, now I'm back to the point where I actually want to do videos again. I'm having fun again. And so if I got something to say, I'll do it. You know, my son has decided that he wants to do some video editing. He's 12, so I figure this is the perfect opportunity. I don't have a million subscribers, you know, I don't even have 500 subscribers. So I figure this is the perfect opportunity to let him get his feet wet, stretch his legs a little bit, and edit some videos. And so far, the ones I've seen him do from stuff that I've already done, he's doing pretty well. So if y'all have any comments about the editing of the videos, please remember, he's 12. Be kind. If you're going to be a jackwagon about it, I'll block the comment. But constructive criticism, that's always welcome. If you have a suggestion for something he could do a little different, always welcome. I promise you, we will not get mad. but just be nice. That's all we're asking. But yeah, so anyway, as you can see here, this car is really easy to drive. It's not overly sensitive. Once you get the lines down with it, and the unexpected brake markers, because you can brake so much sooner. Yeah, once you get all that down, it's a really, really fun little car to drive. It's a shame that Gran Turismo doesn't do more races for stuff like this. You know, give us a race where we can use this car. It's a shame that they don't do that. They've got so many tracks. Yes, people are always asking for new tracks, which is understandable, but there's so many tracks on this game already. There's 80 variations of tracks. You know, this track alone has several variations. So, yeah, I think it'd just be... It'd be really cool to see, like, a Daihatsu Copen race at Tokyo Expressway Center Loop. You know, just something like that. You know, just keep things interesting. Make things a little different. Alright, so far we're at the 201.5. 201.1 is the optimum. I ran a test session with this car a little while ago, and it said I could get down to a 159.6. So, that's not bad on this track. This is a pretty power-hungry track. So, that's not all bad. The feel of the car is good. It really is. It's not... There's not a ton of drama to it. I know some cars, if you breathe on them wrong, they get oversteery or understeery or whatever. This one, on the racing soft tires, because it doesn't have a ton of power, it just kind of sticks where you want it to go, for the most part. It will slide a little bit, but not nearly enough to cause a problem. So yeah, I mean, this is just good fun. And I want to tell you all why I chose this track. I'm pretty good at this track. I like this track. I know a lot of people like to run their time trials for vehicles at Nürburgring, but in all honesty, if I started getting into like the Tomahawks and some of the Bugatti VGT and the cars that have like really high power ratios, my brain just doesn't work that fast. I am 54 years old. I do not have the reflexes that I used to have. I don't think it would work all that well. You might get a really big laugh out of it, but basically what you'd be doing is laughing the entire time, watching me run off the track and curse about it. So, I had suggested to a friend of mine a while back that I was going to start doing, because I am so bad at Nürburgring. I've always hated that track. I never wanted to bother getting any better at it. I just don't race that track at all, ever. But I figured probably at some point I should probably work on getting better at it. So I decided to, I thought about, just doing live streams, and start at the bottom with the slower cars. I'm not talking like the Fiat that has the, 16 horsepower or whatever it is, but lower power range cars, and just to learn the track, and then work my way up from there and do it on live stream, because there's been several times where I've been running that track and I find myself going full on Yosemite Sam with it, because I'll run off the track and just fast it tight, stuff like that. So, and my friends think that's hilarious. So I don't know, I might either. You know what? Y'all let me know in the comments. If you made it this far into the video, let me know in the comments if you think that might be a good idea. Just for sheer entertainment value, laughing at some chubby pleb trying to get around Nürburgring. But as we're coming up here, about three quarters of the way through this last lap, we're running currently about a tenth ahead of what our fastest time was. So yeah, that's not bad. It's not going to be even remotely the fastest lap of all the cars that I do here, but we're just gonna see what see where it stands in its in the PB range it's in. I think this is the only one that is in this range, so I'm not sure how it's gonna stand up in general. I know it's probably gonna be one of the slowest ones, but like I said, it is fun. So yeah, I hope you all enjoyed this video. As we come across the line, excuse me, it's a 2 minutes flat 683. That's pretty good. I'll give this little car credit for that one. I'm sure there are people out there who can get it around the track faster than I can, and that's all good. All I know is this car, in my opinion, it's really good for a beginner to get into. You know, just it's easy. It's really easy. And for me, that's one thing when I was first starting out, I wish I had known is which cars were the easiest ones to handle. Because I just kind of, when I started playing GT Sport, I just jumped into the fire and started running, you know, I started off with the Mustang as far as the race cars, and that thing, it was a handful. So, yeah, I wish I had known as far as those cars, which race cars were easier to drive. Excuse me. So, yeah, I hope this is this series winds up being informative. It's going to be part of a big playlist here on the channel. So, I appreciate you all tuning in. And until next time, everybody, be the calm amid the chaos. Alright, so obviously the Daihatsu Copen is going to be first on the Vision Gran Turismo list. Yeah, so, alright, we're going to see what we can do with the rest of the VGT cars over the next few weeks. And I hope you all stay tuned. Ring the notification bell so you don't miss when I put one of these up if you like them. So, yeah, until next time.